Hey everyone, this is Eric Troy from strengthminded.com and culinarylore.com, and you're listening to the BS Vaccine for Fitness and Nutrition podcast, a series that is meant to help inoculate you against fitness, nutrition, and health-related bullshit, and teach you some very useful critical thinking skills along the way. In this episode, I'm going to explain some things about olive oil that you really need to know, and I'm going to debunk a myth about using olive oil for cooking. I was recently watching a video where a cardiologist was attempting to debunk the on-again, off-again rumor that coconut oil, not olive oil, coconut oil is bad for you. He was reacting to a recent American Heart Association release where they said that coconut oil was absolutely bad for you and it raised bad cholesterol. Before I move on, it's important for me to say that it's pertinent that he's a cardiologist. We can't always rely on authority figures or even doctors to know everything. We have to learn to do our own research and do our own thinking. That's what this podcast is mostly about. I just happen to know something this doctor doesn't know, and you're going to know it too when we're done. But I'm not saying I know more than a doctor. So anyway, this cardiologist was complaining about the American Heart Association saying that coconut oil was bad for you. This doctor himself, a member of the association, said that he cooked with lard, butter, and coconut oil because they are mostly saturated fat and thus stable when cooking. He seemed to think that all other unsaturated oils are completely unstable when heated, even in regular cooking. So he said, I never cook with olive oil because it completely breaks down to trans fat when heated. This is not the first time I've heard this kind of thing said about olive oil. It's a persistent rumor. Is this true? Is olive oil, since it's not a saturated fat, break down when heated and lose its health benefits? Well, I'll start by telling you, or admitting to you, that I immediately stopped watching the video because the expert, in attempting to dispel one myth, brought up another one. I had no patience on that day to try to figure out which of his further statements may be credible, since he started with a complete, absolute, and authoritarian statement about olive oil that is untrue. And this was the same kind of authoritarian statement he complained about regarding coconut oil being bad for you. He just liked coconut oil. So the short answer is no. Olive oil is quite stable when heated and does not break down into lots of bad things like trans fats. Olive oil, unlike many other vegetable oils, even ones with higher smoking points, is mostly monounsaturated fat. Both extra virgin olive oil and regular olive oil will form a minuscule amount of trans fats when heated, but not enough to significantly impact your health. Trans fats are present in nature, but used to be found in much larger amounts in margarine and vegetable shortenings. However, the fact that this cardiologist focused on trans fats from heating uncovers another leak in his theoretical dam. Trans fats are but one of the compounds that may be produced by heating oil, and not even the most significant. A researcher more familiar with the problem would probably have mentioned something like volatile aldehydes and other oxidative byproducts. Olive oil has been shown in at least one study to produce fewer volatile aldehydes than canola oil when subjected to cooking temperatures. When olive oil is heated, it's not only the heat stability of the oil that needs to be considered, but its resistance to oxidation. Olive oil, due to its high amount of monounsaturated fat, not to mention antioxidant content, is more resistant to oxidation than, say, regular canola oil, or oils high in polyunsaturated fatty acids like sunflower oil. In fact, in head-to-head studies with other common cooking oils, olive oil displayed higher stability under heat and better oxidative resistance, retaining its good qualities even with prolonged heating at temperatures used for deep frying for up to 6 hours. You may read about the dangers of cooking oils with low smoke points. So keep in mind that the temperature at which an oil begins to break down does not correlate with its smoke point. Oils with very high smoke points can even begin to break down at lower temperatures than an oil with a lower smoke point like olive oil. And the smoking point of olive oil is not as low as commonly believed and could be considered moderate. Another thing to keep in mind is that when you fry foods over high heat using oil, bad things do occur. Those volatile aldehydes, for instance, will occur when you cook a steak on a stove using olive oil, butter, soybean oil, etc. This doesn't mean that they're present in high enough amounts to be of concern to your health. Even in the comparison of olive oil to canola oil, the fact that you'll be exposed to fewer volatile aldehydes when using olive oil is good, but that doesn't mean you should be mortally afraid of canola oil. And yes, canola oil is fine. The plain truth is, olive oil is great for cooking. The fact is, test after test has demonstrated that olive oil retains its nutritional and health benefits even after being heated for ridiculous amounts of time. One test showed that while not all olive oil is the same, olive oil in general is remarkably resistant to heat-induced breakdown, and clearly a superior choice to most other vegetable oils, being able to resist significant oxidation for up to 24 to 27 hours of heating. What's more, there's evidence that when vegetables are cooked in olive oil, the phenolic and antioxidant compounds within the vegetable themselves increase. The type and proportion of these compounds vary depending on the characteristics of the vegetables themselves and the type of cooking, but all in all, it's a win for olive oil. The take-home here is simple. Olive oil is very stable when heated and much more stable than most other vegetable oils. The next best, in terms of stability, are probably coconut oil and avocado oil. The many health benefits of olive oil are well retained when you use it for cooking. If you believe olive oil to be a healthful addition to your diet, then there is no reason to avoid cooking with it whatsoever. Using it as a dressing, or in an unheated state, of course, is also a very good idea. Note that none of this is meant to compare olive oil with animal-derived oil such as butter or lard, like our cardiologist was talking about. It's meant to only address the myth that olive oil is highly unstable when heated under cooking conditions. Not only is this not true, but olive oil is exceedingly stable for very long periods of time, even at heats used for deep frying.